If you want information from somebody, what's the first thing you do?
Previously seen on Traitors.
I'd find out his weakness and then I'd exploit it.
The executive committee will never approve drug testing.
But what I have in mind, I don't need approval.
We got something to hide.
Yeah.
I say that we tell Cunningham that he can take his urine testing and piss off.
Thank you.
I did what I did so nobody would have to know.
This is an industry based on one overriding concept, Jack. Money doesn't smell.
This money stinks.
The whole truth and nothing but the truth. So help you God.
I do.
So you have to lie?
Guess I let a cause obscure my judgment, huh?
So grow or die. Phase one, buy us out. Phase two, squeeze us out. Now, the bank has made us an offer. Either we accept it or we go into phase two.
We've been down this road 1,000 times, Adam.
Things change, Jack.
They're the last major bank that's looking for a brokerage.
I don't care!
I do. 32 a share is hard to say no to.
No. That wasn't so hard, was it?
No.
The landscape is changing. The day of the independent is over.
3 months ago, you were ready...
Wait a minute. We have your vote?
No.
Motion carried. I'll take this to the shareholders on Friday.
You're selling out.
The bank is being more than generous.
You're selling out at a premium. There have to be options.
Oh, yeah? Name one.
We can keep on going it alone, that's one.
We can only play with the majors as long as they let us.
And our next offer, Jack, is going to be $21 a share.
If there is a next offer.
Grow or die, Jack.
My letter of resignation will be effective the moment this deal's ratified.
For the bank.
Would you like 10s or 20s, sir?
At 32 a share, I can live with a pay cut.
Well, I'm voting against.
Well, you're spitting in the wind. The vote is a lock, with or without any of our support.
It's a point of principle.
Seriously?
What, I can't have principles?
Oh, sure you can, Chris. Just not ones you actually live by.
I was this close to launching a new fragrance worldwide. Then the CEO got cold feet and the board pulled the plug. Stupid move. And I didn't stay quiet about it.
They dumped you?
From the board. Oh, they kept me on as VP for the sake of appearances. But now I'm in limbo. They won't fire me, and they won't include me in the loop.
I know the feeling.
I want to launch a leverage buyout. Grenfell Cosmetics is crumbling. Hell, its signature perfume dates back to the 70s. It's crying out for new blood.
Susanna said you needed these.
Oh, I'll take them.
First night.
Thank you, Ms. Blake. You can go.
I love that perfume.
My company makes it.
Well, I can't afford it. You know, always something needing fixing or the kid's bike gets stolen.
We have business.
Oh, sorry.
That is exactly the kind of customer Grenfell Cosmetics should tap into. The insignificant office girl.
It's my sister.
No offense.
No, I'm untaken.
Checkout clerk, the sales girl, that's our future.
We'll go after the offshore investments first. Do we have friendly insiders?
Stay away from the board. They're all dupes of the CEO.
Who is he?
She.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Don't be. Lynette Grenfeld. My mother.
Take it.
You really going?
Sale goes through, yeah.
So you're going.
Grenfell Cosmetics.
Class A or B?
Anything with a vote.
Okay, hard or soft.
Can you keep it quiet as long as you can? There it is.
Smoking or not smoking?
You bring it under 18?
Yeah, all right. Okay, folks, we're going after Grenfell Cosmetics. You know the routine.
We're going to miss you, Larkin.
Yeah, you had your chance.
Yeah, we're all broke up about it.
Please. Ashes to ashes, dust to dust.
Someone die, Grant?
Not someone, something.
What do we do?
We're investment bankers.
Yeah, I know, but What do we actually do?
Buy, sell stocks, look for investment opportunities.
What about Jack's perfume deal?
His client is buying a cosmetics company.
And Jack?
Helps.
How much does he charge for that help?
$200 for solicitation, another $200 for shared amounts, $77 million takeover, 1.2% advisory. That is 1.3 mil.
1.324.
We'll round it off.
You'll just forget about $24,000.
It doesn't look good to be taking every nickel off the table.
A $24,000 nickel?
Yeah.
So you guys get this just for buying stuff for someone else with someone else's money.
A deal is like making chocolate pudding.
Seems like you guys get dessert every day.
Now, we're just the kid helping Mom. We don't make it, we don't own it. We just mix it up a little, and then in return...
Mom lets you lick the spoon.
Yeah.
Do you want to report to three levels of senior management? You want to be a glorified civil servant?
Debate's over, Jack.
We sell to the bank. You might as well install a time clock behind reception.
This is a business decision.
It's a bad decision.
And your decision to quit?
I love what I do.
Yes, Anton Lieben for you.
Excuse me. This is personal.
Yes, Miss Ross?
Tell Mr. Lieben I'm in a meeting.
Well, it's not the hardware.
Screen's still locked.
Yeah, scuzzy transport failure. May I? What are you doing here?
Derivatives, unless they do me first.
Yeah, what's a derivative?
Oh, it's like futures without the commodity, sometimes virtual futures.
Sounds complicated. There you go, you're back online.
Thank you.
Wow.
It's a chaotic forecast model.
It's beautiful. Did you coat this? Cool. Bye.
We agreed, huh? No lockup. I take the money and I'm out of here.
Agree to stay, and the banks authorized me to up the offer. Another $2 per share right across the board.
Can't do it.
Adam, what was your best year, 86? We'll guarantee you make at least that for each of the next 3 years.
It's not about the money.
It's always about the money.
True. But I'm not staying on.
Then I can't push this deal through.
Well, now, wait a minute. We had an agreement.
Before I heard that Jack Larkin was quitting. Come on, Adam. Gardner Ross is people. Without the people, what the hell's my bank supposed to be buying?
I'm not staying on.
Well, one of you better. Your choice, your problem.
Where are we?
Just above 9%. We should have a tender offer by tomorrow.
Price movement?
Minimal. It's up like...
Darby!
Actually, it's down a half.
How'd you do that?
Well, I'm a genius.
Jack, make the announcement.
Okay, keep buying Grenfell, people. Fast and hard. Come on.
Have you read the announcement? No, I just told you to make it.
Excuse me. Hey. I said excuse me. Read the one-liner.
Grenfell Cosmetics is the target of a takeover bid. You are great!
Just keep reading, please.
Grenfell Cosmetics is the target of fine work, excellent prose.
Soon to be a major motion picture. Just keep reading.
Grenfell Cosmetics is the target of a takeover bid announced today by Dorian Industries.
It's not our announcement.
Dorian's represented by Ian Dancer.
Geez, is he the only broker in town? This isn't a coincidence.
I agree. Dorian Industries is Grenfell Cosmetics' main supplier and has been for a number of years. Also, Oscar Dorian is Annette Grenfell's godson.
The White Knight.
In all likelihood.
Yeah, but protecting them from what?
From us.
But we hadn't even made the takeover announcement.
No, somebody did.
Do you think we have another leak?
I think we got a client with a big mouth. That's what I think.
It's not about the money, Adam.
$2 more per share if you stay. Of course, the bank's insane, but who am I to argue?
What's the matter, Adam? You're not rich enough yet?
Not even close. But hey, it's not about me, Jack. I mean, there's Grant, right? Anne, Benny, every one of the shareholders. I'm sure that Donald could use the money. And you just agree to keep on doing your job.
I can't do it!
They're prepared to dump a truckload of cash for your lockup.
But my job is corporate finance, not a bank lackey.
You're going to cost your friends and co-workers a great deal of money by playing with semantics.
It's not semantics, Adam. It's why I came here.
I'm not hungry.
You don't have to eat it. Just recommend it.
It's macaroni and cheese.
It's good macaroni and cheese.
How good does macaroni and cheese get?
Pretty damn good.
I'm way too busy for this, Kathy.
This is going to be huge. You do not want to miss this.
You got 30 seconds. Give me your pitch.
It tastes great.
You still got 25 seconds.
You raise a family on a budget, you will kill for a 69-cent meal that tastes great.
That's it? The company, the balance sheet, management, distribution, suppliers. You got anything like that?
My friends all love it.
You believe in the product? Get me some data. Now, go to your job and let me do mine.
I'm swamped, Grant.
I'm in love, Donald.
Congratulations, what do you want?
Just to tell you I'm in love.
Okay. What's her name?
Magda.
Magda, does she have a last name?
Everybody has a last name, Donald, except some of the big superstars, but she's not a big superstar.
Do you know her last name, Grant?
Hi, love doesn't ask for a person's last name. At least I didn't.
What'd she look like?
Well, she looks... I could pick her out in a crowd.
Oh, yeah, that's love.
She made my computer run.
The computer repair woman?
I only hope I'm worthy.
Grant, how long have you known her for?
What has time got to do with love?
Well, what does last names have to do with love?
Exactly.
Well, you know, thanks for telling me all about it. Best of luck. I gotta go out there.
How do I get her to go out with me?
Well, you call her.
No.
Yes.
No, I can't talk to her on the phone.
Well, then write her a letter.
Well, people who store letters are the phone company and my aunt from England.
Have you tried telepathy, Grant?
It's too inaccurate. I might end up with a Martha or a Mary or a Mark.
You're going to have to figure out where she goes, and you're going to have to go there.
Go anywhere.
Whoa.
Susanna won't listen to me.
It's not her job to listen to you. It's your job to listen to her.
She's looking for new investment opportunities,
you're not
right?
Listening to me.
I got this great product.
You haven't changed, you know
she
that?
Just blows me off, says she's too busy.
What the hell do you want me to do about it?
I want you to talk to her.
You are a piece of work, you know that?
I'm right about this.
I don't give a damn who's right about it. You're Susanna's clerk, and you don't deserve that job. So if you want to hang on to it, you better start earning your keep.
You pay me $24,000 a year.
Let's hope you last that long. Take those boxes with you.
No, I'm not your clerk.
It's a present for your kid. It's a drum kit for his birthday.
Sean turned 9 last week.
Stick it in the closet till he's 10.
You know who you remind me of?
Nothing we discuss should be repeated. Not to anybody. Not to your best friend. Not to your therapist. Not to your waiter.
I've got a big mouth, but I'm not an idiot. All right. Let's call and raise, top the Dorian bid.
You play poker.
Does that surprise you?
Well, that's great, but you don't play very well, okay? You're going to bid yourself right out of the game. Dorian's got the deeper pockets. We can't afford to go head-to-head with him. It won't work.
Watch me.
Did you ever wonder why you're paying us an advisory fee on this? I don't think you're trying to take over a company. I think you're trying to destroy your mother.
On this deal and in this room, she is not my mother. She's a CEO who is mismanaging a company. Nail her.
What are you gonna do?
I'm gonna become a monk! They're still men, right?
Yeah, as far as I know.
The woman plays poker, I still can't get to her thick skull.
Well, you've never seemed to have a problem
personally,
with...
Personally, no, not a problem, other than family. Business, huge problem.
Hi.
Hi, guys.
Hi.
Excuse me.
Hi. They're just people, Jack.
As if they like us to think.
Because I'm a woman?
Yeah. Oh.
Miss Rossi's arrived here. Shall I place some water?
No, just... Do whatever you want with him. Cosmetics company. Because I know all about mascara and lipstick.
Would that be so crazy?
Oh, no. Just a little minimizing.
I need your expertise. But not on that stuff. I can't control Anne in London.
Controller?
She can't get past her personal feelings.
And I have a particular expertise in that area?
Yeah. No. No. Come on, I need your help.
Let's start by keeping the mother busy. Marty, buy Dorian.
Oh, wait. We're not after Dorian. We're after Grenfell Cosmetics.
Well, takeover targets go up. The company's taking them over, tend to go down. I think that was Newton's fourth law.
Dorian Industries doesn't want Grenfell Cosmetics. They're only at the table because we are.
Well, that's kind of the definition of a white knight.
The client's into poker, right?
Yeah, but she refuses to use the card she was dealt.
Your opponent bluffs. Do you fold?
Oh. Go after Dorian.
The client couldn't afford Grenfell. She sure as hell can't afford Dorian.
We're not buying.
What's a bluff?
Dorian's on the block, people. Buy, buy, buy. Make big noises, Chris. Just keep hitting every ask. Trickle it back out very quietly. Get what you can. Bluff.
Here to congratulate me on blocking Jack's bid for Grenfell Cosmetics.
Here to offer you a job.
You're certainly handling this with maturity.
Well, it's a perfect fit, Ian. You've certainly experienced bank ownership firsthand. Outstanding track record.
Yeah. I'm great. But I thought Larkin was your point man in corporate finance.
Larkin's a loose cannon. I think it's time we considered investing in a higher grade of investment banker.
Turned down the bank deal, did he?
I'm just sick of his antics.
What are they prepared to offer me?
Well, I think it's pretty safe to count on a 30% bump in your current position, 2-year guarantee.
Has the bank given approval to this?
Not yet, but I don't think it's going to be a problem.
Well, if they like Larkin, they'll love me. I was handling the Grenfell Cosmetics defense almost before Jack knew there was an offense. He spotted some peculiar trading.
No, the trade was clean. I checked it myself.
Somebody invested $800 in Grenfell Cosmetics.
Yeah. Somebody invested a hell of a lot more than that.
Not this person. The interesting thing wasn't the amount so much as who.
You're really enjoying this, aren't you?
Very much. One of your employees opened an account with one of our brokers. That's the sort of thing that catches my interest.
I'm sure it would.
I figured your person knew there was something up over at Grenfell Cosmetics.
Oh, I see. So you hightailed it over to Lynette and threw yourself across the barricades, huh? What was the name?
Kathy Blake.
Kathy.
Amused?
Yeah, very. It's Jack's sister.
I want a 45% bump and a 3-year guarantee.
Yeah, well, we'll certainly get back to you. Well, stay in touch.
Okay, give me everything you got. Okay, we got 50,000 Grenfell. Do you want me to keep buying more?
Well, if it's not too inconvenient, then.
They're seeing me coming a mile away here. We're getting reamed.
Good.
Buy high, sell low. This some kind of new strategy, Mart?
Buy loud, sell quiet. What are you supposed to be doing?
Selling.
And how do we sell?
Quietly.
Then shut up!
But thanks to Chris, everyone knows we're on the buy side.
That's kind of the idea, Benny. Try New York, try London, try Buenos Aires.
They have an exchange there?
Find out! Find out!
You, finally lost it, Marty?
Go play with your dolls, will you? Leave me alone.
Benny! What's happening? Give me the news.
I don't know.
Well, learn fast.
I can't.
Marty, just hold on. My computer is locked here.
Yeah, whatever that is, it happened to mine, too.
God.
We just tucked half our trading capital away in cyberspace.
Get me the TSE-300.
Get me Reuters. I need Reuters.
Get me the TSE-300.
Get out of here. I've got business to do. Come
just
on.
Because you're on a different network doesn't mean you're not part of this floor. Buying Dorian is a priority.
Not to my clients.
I still only have one working unit.
I know. Everything looks right.
But... you know, unless these things are desk lamps, it strikes me that everything is not right. You know, it's not even close to right. It's downright wrong. Make them work!
Nice talking to you, Manny.
Seidelman! This is no time to be socializing!
Just bought another 5,000 Dorian, Mart.
Your computer's up?
Nah. This is just like the old days in the exchange before these boob tubes were invented. Ticker and phone.
Ticker's way behind the market. You don't even know the real price.
So? Hey, Craterhead, how you stocked on Dorian? I'll take it at an eighth below.
Eighth below what?
Shut up! They don't know. Benny doesn't know.
Yeah. Done. Right. I'll take it at... okay. Thanks. 10 3/8.
10 3/8! Okay, you got the actual price now, you toads? Stop harassing Ann and do as Benny does.
I don't believe this. We're bluffing our way through a bluff.
You love what you do, huh?
It's my last deal, and it's cursed!
What's going on?
Computers are down. Find Dorian.
Okay.
No, I'm buying Dorian.
I can come back if this isn't
a good time. No. I said I'm buying Dorian. I'll take it. Well, no. No, you can do better. No.
Which one?
Number two, definitely. Done. Definitely. Okay.
What is that?
It's a macaroni challenge.
Well, macaroni tastes the same. I didn't say I didn't want any. Buying Dorian.
I only meant to knock out my own.
Fix it.
No.
Grant, this is sabotage.
I'm sending up a desperate flare of love.
Grant,
please. Nice metaphor, huh?
Remember, I read a poem.
I cannot do it. I can only rhyme a little
bit. Grant! Okay. Okay, you got what you want. She's out there. You can go talk to her.
Out there on the floor?
Grant, you're messing up a major deal.
What's money compared to love? Nothing. Zero. Zip. Niente. Nada. Diddly. Goose egg.
That's a terrible price. That's also a terrible price. Yeah, okay, I'll take that.
Tastier?
Premier.
You want some?
No. Oh, thanks. Magda? Are you Magda?
Yeah.
Neighbor along, Donald.
Come with me, please.
I've got work to do.
Grant Jansky wants to go out with you.
No.
Yeah.
Derby!
Just please.
He didn't say anything.
He can't. Come on.
Whoa. Get back there, right? Come on.
No. The defect in the system is of an emotional nature, Marty.
Oh, well, I'm phoning security.
Go. Come here. Trust me.
Tried the macaroni challenge?
Shut up.
How about the kiss my butt challenge?
That I've tried.
Black hole, squat, rien, none. Opposite of a lot, less than a little. Big donut hole.
Hi.
He says hi.
I really should get back to the
floor.
No. Don't go.
Ask her, Grant.
Yes.
I'd love to.
Oh, great. Great. Okay, let's,
When?
Tomorrow's no good. No. Friday.
I'm sorry?
Friday? It's Friday? Friday's good for you? Friday,
yeah.
Good. Friday, Grant. Fix the damn computers.
Of course I'm not calling you a liar. No, I can see it right here. It's right here in front of me. Here. I ever tell you the one about the stockbroker named One Eye Pete? Yeah. Hey. Come on. All right. Done at 5/8. Hang on. Ah, jeez! He smoked me. One Eye Pete, he slept with your wife.
All right, word to the wise, folks. The street knows we're on the blink. What's your positions?
Beats the hell out of me.
I'm not even sure of some of the prices I paid.
I think I sold some stuff that we don't even own.
Hey, Marty.
Not now. And have Donald killed.
Yeah, okay. Listen, report came over orders 5 minutes ago. Dorian withdrew their bid for Grenfell. They bought the bluff.
5 minutes ago?
Yeah. They good?
Oh, that's very good, yes. Okay, let's just clean up this mess. Benny, good work.
Hey, thanks.
Yeah, you can have my macaroni.
Hey, I already did.
I hope the Dorian thing didn't put too big a dent in our war chest.
I have no idea.
None whatsoever.
3,487,229.
How the hell do you know that?
Computer is working.
Yeah, oh!
87% found it significantly tastier. 50% identified the creaminess. 12% described it as more velvety. That was Benny.
This is not scientific data.
Oh, I got that too. The company went public 12 months ago. It's based in Edmonton.
This is really gonna have to wait.
It can't.
It can.
Their first annual report is being released today at 3. The stock is barely trading at book value. If the sales results are anywhere near what I think, it's got to go up.
I would like to see Miss Ross, Anton Lieben.
I'm sorry, Mr. Lieben, but she's not in today.
Thank you for your time.
You're welcome.
Hell did you think you were doing?
We bought some stock, we sold some stock. If Dorian thought they were in play, that's not my problem.
Little bluff must have cost your client a bundle.
Don't mourn your little white knight cost your client, buddy.
I have a proposal which will avoid
As of this morning, your client is dismissed from her post as vice president at Grenfell Cosmetics.
In a week, my client's gonna be CEO!
Lynette is prepared to spend Aileen's inheritance fighting for the company.
Jack, I want to be able...
Aileen has instructed me to divide up the company to pay for the damn financing!
You think we intend to pass the company on to your client intact?
Do you seriously think your minority shareholders are going to swallow a poison pill?
Gentlemen! This meeting is adjourned.
Who's that all
about? You tell me.
He was out of line.
You were better?
That's what our client wants.
It's not what she needs.
Well, it's what they're paying us for.
You should have no trouble working for the bank.
Buying Grenfield at a half.
Marty. 70,000 at 7/8.
Overpriced is new object.
Done.
Selling Dorian. Yeah, I know, but now I'm begging you to buy it. No, I said beg, not grovel. Done at 3/8.
How many gen load?
10,000.
Yeah, well, start groveling. Oh, that the Lord did not raise his hand against insider trading. Oh, I can make a fortune on Grenfeld.
Well, Jack and Dancer are a pretty even match. You couldn't possibly know which way it's going to go.
Yeah, well, I'm talking long term.
Oh, 5 minutes?
5 months. Whoever wins, you're gonna have to do it by tearing that company apart. Price shares, boom, right through the floor. It's obvious, family feud.
Well, you know the old adage, beware the obvious.
No, I know the one, finders keepers, losers weepers.
Private word, Jack?
You can have any word you want, Adam. Can you pass me those gloves?
Think so. You're not going anywhere.
Take it like a man, Adam.
Ian Dancer told me why he was able to scoop you on the Grenfell deal. Seems that your sister was guilty of insider trading.
You believed him?
Of course not. I checked. But don't worry about Dancer. It's in his best interest to be discreet. But it's not in mine. So you quit, your sister goes to jail. You agree to a 3-year lockup with the bank. That information never leaves this room.
Yes, yeah. Have you read it? Well, we'll read it and call me, okay? Yeah. Nail polish and hairspray divisions, John. Yeah, yeah. Well, check the demographics. You can't go wrong. Okay. Yes, okay, bye.
What are you doing?
Hello. Marching orders, selling off divisions of Grenfell Cosmetics.
We don't even own it.
Yeah, once we own it, we'll have to sell it. Most of it, anyway.
Paying off the debt with the bones of the company.
Probably. Hello?
Who the hell is Jack?
Yes, Donald.
You're late. You took advantage of your position.
Oh, you guys mix the pudding and you get $1 million spoon.
What the hell are you talking about?
I made $700.
I don't care how much money you make.
Oh, you can afford not to care. Well, not in my world. Hey, look at what you do, Jack. Huh? You don't create anything. You play with what other people created, and then you ride on their glory. Well, none of this is real.
You broke the law!
So turn me in. Have me arrested because I played in your sandbox.
You're going to cancel your account with Ian Dancer. You're going to go to Susanna, and you're going to tell her you're quitting. And you're going to be out of here by the end of the day.
Get off your hands.
Sally.
I thought you wanted my help on this deal.
I do. I want your help when I have a problem. I don't have a problem right now.
This deal is being driven by personal animosity.
I know. That's why I'm trying to put it on a business footing.
Try emotional quicksand. It swallowed you and Dancer.
Should I leave?
No! This is business.
When was the last time those two women were in the same room together?
That's the problem with this deal. It's already way too personal.
No. The problem is it's not personal enough. We have to be... Oh, God.
There's it.
Must be some new efficiency thing.
Well, it's not working.
My date.
Grant, your date's in 3 days.
You're making a fool of yourself.
I know.
Upstairs.
Hey, excuse me? I've got a date. Do you guys charge by the hour?
I'm trying to run a business.
And you strolled in here in the middle of the day with a bunch of musicians.
I wanted to talk to you.
And I obviously didn't want to talk to you. And you have no right to force this on me.
I love you.
I can't pretend your wife doesn't exist. I can't pretend that you...
You're not talking about my wife. Do you love me?
No. We're not talking about whether I love you or not. You lied to me.
Yes, I did. And I'm so sorry. Sally, do you love me?
No. No, I don't. No, I don't love you.
Perhaps we are now even.
London is at reception.
Ms. Grenfell.
I expect an explanation of the emergency that requires my client's presence.
Please, come this way.
This your idea of fun? Ambushing other people's clients?
No, actually, my idea of fun is letting Larkin tear apart your client's company. He's in his office.
I'll join you in a moment.
This meeting is long overdue.
We can communicate perfectly well through our advisors.
I couldn't agree more.
We've already lined up buyers for your European skincare product.
Too bad. We've got a legal opinion on our rights issue. You'll never get through the door.
A poison pill will be approved by the board first thing in the morning. This deal is simply out of your price range.
In order to finance this transaction, I will have to sell off a number of your more obsolete divisions, something I intended to do at any price. Let's cut the crap, shall we, ladies? Sit down, Lynette. Aileen? This isn't about business. This is about some problem in your past, some major dysfunction, or perhaps minor dysfunction. I don't need to know. But I know you'd better solve it. Or when the guys on the other side of that wall are through, you will be left with nothing. And I'm not just talking about business.
What a load of sentimental drivel.
Totally.
Not for a moment do I doubt that you put her up to this. I'm firm in my commitment to Grenfell.
No one would be foolish enough to think you were capable of softening up on anything.
Don't make this personal.
I'm not the one prepared to unload my company to anyone but my daughter.
When you grow up, I'll give you the company.
Oh, please, I'd have to pry it away from you even if you were dead.
You're a child, and that is exactly why.
You can't admit that I'm an adult, because then you'll be forced to admit that you're old.
How dare you?
You're old, Mother. Your time has passed you by.
You have no respect for anything I've ever done for you.
For me? You've never done anything for me.
Our clients are yelling at each other.
I know.
You don't have a problem with that?
You guys yell at each other all the time.
That's business.
This is personal.
That's better?
Much. Are you still betting against the future of Grenfell Cosmetics?
Naturally.
Care to make it interesting?
Oh, 500 interesting?
You're on. I didn't mention, did I, the Grenfell dynasty are actually meeting face to face? I predict a reconciliation.
I already know that. Jack says they're screaming at each other.
Oh.
The yelling stopped. Should we?
Oh, after you.
Oh, they'll tell us when they're ready.
Sally?
They're ready. We've reached certain accommodations.
First, I'm bringing Aileen back onto the board, which of course means...
No takeover bid.
We're not finished yet.
We've decided that Grenfell Cosmetics must grow.
While maintaining its core franchise.
But primarily, our focus will be on growth.
No, primarily our focus will be on maintaining what brought this company
to the brink of disaster. We can work out the business details later. The company was built on a sound foundation.
Which is why it can survive a difference of opinion. We still have some matters to discuss, so if you don't mind. Sally?
She always like this?
She's no worse than your client.
Not the clients, your boss.
Oh, yeah, she's always like that.
It's good karma. Lousy business.
Not really. They want us to acquire Dorian Industries.
Jointly? Good karma. Good business.
Something to consider, I guess.
Susanna.
Sorry, Kathy. We've got a full shareholders meeting in 2 minutes.
I can't work here anymore. It's not right for me.
No, you're great.
I got another job offer. It starts right away. More money. I know I should have given you notice, but...
Oh, could I have more of this macaroni?
Knock yourself out.
Hey, I owe you on this stuff. Made $50,000 on that recommendation.
Congratulations.
No wonder you got another job offer.
So we have an offer of $32 a share to purchase Gardner Ross, and we need a majority decision from the shareholders to ratify it. So I vote yes. Grant?
I abstain.
Susanna?
Yes.
Chris?
No.
Marty?
Yes.
And Sally?
I vote no.
What did you say?
I no longer believe that the sale to the bank is in my best interest.
Grow or die. No options.
Issue our own stock. Go public.
It's brilliant.
You'd like anything better than selling to the bank.
True.
We retain our independence while creating a pool of capital that will allow us to stay competitive.
Danzer can do the issue.
He's a shark, Jack.
Yeah.
So what do we do with this new capital?
Big bonuses all around.
Shut up. We purchase a merchant bank. Where the profits are. I want Gardner Ross to be there before the banks clue into that fact.
I love it.
Who's going to fix the computers?
Shut up.
This is a very bad business decision.
It's a good decision. I love what I do.
Margaret called from Tucson. She said she saw a beautiful ranch home just a few blocks from her. It has a garden and a view.
The deal collapsed.
It's okay.
I don't know, I just wondered. I was hoping.
I know. It's all right, dear. I love the snow. I'd miss it.